Hey, what's up, man?
Cyraxx, what's good, man? Chance, you were right about everything.
What's going on? Joe Andy, what's up?
I was listening to music, man. That's why I didn't hear the call too well. Am I coming in good to you, though?
Oh, yeah. Plain as day, dude. You're good.
Yeah, I got these audio problems, bro. I got this shitty thing. Hey, Matt, what's good, brother?
Nothing much.
Oh, man.
How's it going, bro?
It's been a time for me, Cyraxx. Both my parents have died. Oh, man, you were right about everything. I shouldn't have trusted those Betty White acolytes or whatever the fuck they were called.
Wait, what happened exactly? Like, Phil, like... Explain from the very beginning, like, what exactly went down.
All right, so they paid me the money to troll you, right? You remember
yeah.
that?
Yeah, I remember that.
And, man, we were good buddy pals for a while, but then they told me that they wouldn't pay me anymore unless I hurt your feelings. And then you said all that shit. I feel like you may have put a curse on me.
Why? What happened?
Because they went after my dead daddy, and now they're going after my dead mommy, and I don't know how to feel about this, Chance. I can't. I needed to come clean tonight on a bunch of things. That UIS... Say what?
Well, wait, hold up. So, wait. Were your parents still alive when we last talked, or were they still...
They were alive when we talked, and now they're gone,
okay, so, what? Hang on, back up. So, side thing here. What exactly happened to your parents? Like, what happened? What went down?
Oh, they just got old and died, but, like...
For natural causes.
But you said my life was going to go to shit. You said that.
And what's crazy, dude, is that wasn't even necessarily a curse. That was just me, like, warning you, like, hey, you keep doing this shit, it's going to go bad real quick.
Those UIS guys? There's a gentleman involved with them named Roddy Beltran, and he's, like, he's even sicker than the shit that they say you do. He draws, like, Donkey Kong porn and, like Billy and...
Yeah, I heard it. I heard a little bit about that guy. I don't know too much about him, but I have caught wind, like, very slightly here and there about what he's about.
He gives Base Shaman, like, hundreds and hundreds of dollars.
Like, yeah. Honestly, coming from Base Shaman and with all that shit, that doesn't necessarily surprise me.
And it's like, Base Shaman's going to make fun of you for, like, shoving a... stick up your ass or whatever that was. Lighter, I don't remember. Flashlight.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about, yeah.
Yeah, and he's going to make fun of you for that. I mean, that's some kinky shit, but, like, this dude is, like, literally got child porn that he's drawing, and his name's Roddy Beltran, and it's fucking sick.
That's what gets me, man. You got people out here like Tony that actually go out of their way and actually do shit, but, dude, you can even ask Matt, dude. What I fell for was a fucking troll. But what's weird to me is they're real quick to go after me, but yet they're not so quick to go after Tony. But Tony's actually done real-life fucking pedo shit. And that's where I'm confused at. It's like I fell for a fucking troll, and I've not done anything like that. I would never try to do anything like that. But, yeah, you got Tony out here doing the same shit as that other dude. But yet, they don't go after him.
I heard you called yourself the Storm recently.
Long story short, me and a couple friends are working on some shit to try to shut these guys down.
Yeah, I called this one pedophile lady. She's kind of hot, bud. She's kind of hot for a freak. But she's a furry, and she likes to use children for bait. For like actual pedophiles, and her name is Kuro Softpaws, and
I think I remember hearing something about her.
She made me so mad, man. I had to unleash the storm on her. I called myself the Storm the same night you called yourself the Storm. Like it lined up.
Okay, that's crazy.
That was the same night, bro. We called ourselves the Storm. Did you actually feel like a possession? Like a storm coming in you, like it approaching and convoking black cloud.
It wasn't so much of a storm as it was like me just feeling like, yo, I finally got a fucking hold on these motherfuckers. It's time to fucking start doing shit.
For real.
Like, I'll be honest, dude, the shit these guys are doing, Like, even you gotta admit, even from a troll perspective, dude, even you gotta admit, dude, the shit they've done has gone way too fucking far.
Yeah, man, you got arrested, you're, like, screaming for Sally and all this shit, and, like...
Well, not only that, dude, but Matt can tell you here recently, one of the trolls, and nobody will admit to this or will take blame for it, and I can understand why, because they don't want to end up getting arrested. So one of the trolls fairly recently, like, when was it, Matt? Like, last week that all that shit happened?
I think so, like something about keying her car or something?
No, somebody ended up taking a brick and destroying our fucking windshield. We literally had to pay over $1,000 just to get it replaced because we didn't have insurance on the windshield, so we had to replace it out of pocket. Dude, I legit got photos, sent it to a few people, and they're just like, what the fuck? Like, this shit's going way too fucking far. I mean, dude, they literally have Facebook groups made about me. All kinds of shit, dude. Like, it's insane at the level that they're going to. Even Marty's moved on. Even Matt can tell you, dude, Marty's done moved on.
Yeah, Nick is Marty's done. Down. If you wanted his court records, we got them, man. Spooky's
well, dude, let's put it this way, dude. Marty's now moving on to Crystal and Leslie.
Yeah, those are like some trailer park people, aren't they?
Yeah. But, dude, he's moved on there. The ones that are screwing with me now are the UIS, William Borehole, obviously, CBG, N-word Boy, and fucking something Wyatt or whatever.
Yeah, that UIS, man, that's some low-tier shit. Like, they're under base shaman. Like, they're a subgroup of base shaman. And it's, like, kind of sad that they fucking suck his dick.
Do you know anything about, like, William or the N-word Boy? Because I know those guys have been, like, riding my shit real. Like, N-word Boy, let's put it this way, dude. He wants me gone, no matter what. Like, there was a post they posted of it. You could tell he was bitching and whining and screaming and just like, oh, I want him gone, blah, blah, blah. And it's like, the fuck? Dude, I'm telling you, man, these guys are acting like little fucking kids.
Yeah, Glory Hole, he's probably a fed.
Honestly, dude, he either works for the feds or knows somebody within the law system.
He knows so much. You know, like, he knew, like, as soon as my dad died, and he got I like that video he made of me. he knew. It's like he's psychic. You know, the storm possesses me when I get angry. That's a recent development in my life, as I get possessed by an entity called the storm. It's a guy in a blue jacket, and he's got white hair, and it's kind of like some Devil May Cry shit. It's pretty cool.
But, like, dude, not gonna lie, man, the shit that they put my family through, dude, that's why me and my family have been trying to figure out, like, how we can deal with these guys. Like, I've obviously got a couple people that are helping me out on the legal side of things, but it's like, before they came along, it's like...
You remember when I gave you all that legal advice?
God, dude, that was so fucking long ago, dude. I'm not gonna lie, dude. That was like, what?
About Castle Domain and all that? Yeah, that was when we first...
Yeah, dude, that was like... Dude, that shit was like... God, I don't even know how long ago, dude. It's been so long now. I know it was before me and Jasmine got together.
Yeah, Jasmine didn't like me at all. She was a troll, though, wasn't she?
No, she actually turned... She turned out she was real. But instead of liking me and wanting me for who I am as a person, she wanted me for, you know, internet-wise type shit. Like, you know, who I was on the internet, not me as a person. Like, she literally wanted to date me just so she can say, like, oh, I dated this dude. And it's like, the fuck? Like, she literally, the one night when we were talking, because we had split up, got back together a few times. And this last time that we ended up back together, she flat out sent me in a text message that she would always be a fan first. And like that to me is like, so you're basically telling me that when it comes down to me and you being together, you see me as this person, but not who I actually am outside of that. Oh, the yeah, fuck's wrong with you?
Oh yeah, buddy.
So I ended up sending her a voice message and cutting her off right then and there because I was like, I knew I deserved better.
Yeah, bud, that's what I was telling you. She was overweight, and she just didn't look too attractive to me. What about that skibbity toilet lady, the other one?
Skibbity toilet lady? Skibbity
Ba,
what?
The one in Australia or something?
Oh, the other jazz.
She was kind of cute. She was kind of cute. Was she for real, or was she just like a troll?
She was real, but she also turned out to be a fucking troll at the same time. Which, that fucking dude, that shit pissed me off, because, like, me and her have a really weird, complicated history. Like, we would fight, argue, be cool with each other. Yo, Matt, you good, bro?
Yeah, Matt, you sound sick, bro. You got something?
I've been coughing.
It's been coughing a lot.
But, like, we would, like, you can ask Matt, dude. Mine and the original Jasmine's relationship was really fucking weird, dude. Like, we would be friends, hating each other for a month or so, going back to talking, dating each other, not dating each other, her splitting up with me, getting back with me, and this and that, and da da da. And after this last time, dude, she basically was like, oh, you're this, you're that, and blah, blah, blah. And I flat out thought, I was like, you know what? I know it's you fucking posting those goddamn messages. I'm not fucking stupid. I know what you were doing. You were sitting there trying to hide that you were sending our text messages and our conversations to Discord groups. Like, do you really think I'm fucking stupid? No. I just didn't say shit because I wanted to try to look past that and be a good fucking person. But since you want to go down this road, well, here's the fucking truth.
Yeah, I didn't want this documented, you know, but like I was gonna tell you about that Roddy from UIS and the court documents we got from Nick B, Marty. But it's so messed up, man. There's a messed up world, you know. You know, Cyraxx, it's so fucked up.
Right. It really is, dude. Like, I'm not gonna lie, dude. Like, it's to the point to where there's only like one, or actually there's really is like only one neighbor, which is right next door to us, that we're cool with. All the rest of the fucking neighbors, for no reason, because of what that dude did when he came down, that dude that came down that I swung out with that bat, yeah, because of him, half my fucking neighborhood now hates my fucking guts.
Yeah, I wanted to ask you about like all that stuff that happened to you after we split off, because I was talking to Earl, that white Bowser bastard, the white bastard. Man, that
yeah.
guy was seriously sick. Like, it came out, like, he jacked off to the animal,
yeah.
touched the boobies, and people were like, oh, he's the next Cyraxx. And I'm like, nah, man, this motherfucker's worse than Chance. Worse than Chance could
right,
ever
right. I felt for a, dude, I felt for a fucking troll. This dude actually went out and that's like, dude, you can't even ask Matt, man. Like, dude, Matt talks to me literally every fucking day. So, like, he can tell you for a fact that I don't fucking go out and do this shit and try to meet up with these supposed kids or whatever that they're trying to say that I'm doing it. I'm like, but yeah, dude, with that white Bowser guy, man, like he definitely did some fucking shit.
Yeah, like
the
only time you talk to kids is on like Fortnite and stuff. Like, you know, you don't even like talk to them. You know what I'm saying? You talk to them through the mic and shit.
Right. Or like, right, or like, you know, if I just happen to be in a lobby of theirs, or they happen to be in mine and their mic's on or whatever, and they're on my team, then yeah, that's one thing entirely,
yeah,
you know?
To those kids, because they're on your team, right?
Right, exactly. I'm not out there, like, going like, oh, let me do this, let me do that. I don't fucking do that shit.
Yeah, that's why I don't play those Fortnite and stuff, you know? I just don't like talking to minors.
For prime example, let's say that me and you hopped in a Fortnite match and like we were totally random people and you ended up on my team. Yeah, I'd talk to you and, you know, chat it up with you and, you know, do what a team's supposed to do and, you know, give you feedback on what's going on and shit. Like, that's
watching your back or something.
Exactly. Like, it's literally team communication. Like, if yo, Matt, you good, bro?
Yeah.
Have you taken any cough drops or any kind of cough meds, dude?
Yeah, take some lean. That'll help. That'll really fucking help, man. I had a little
bit of lean. Knowing him, that'll put in, dude, knowing Matt, believe it or not, dude, Matt doesn't drink like that. But I get hungry right now, dude. That'll put his ass out like a heartbeat. That'll knock his ass out like a light real quick, man. I guarantee you that.
That's why I reached out to Matt, because I was, you know, everything you said, but, you know, it happened. And it's like you were a psychic or something. And I was like, damn.
No, it's not that I'm a psychic, dude. It's just I've been through this shit long enough that, I noticed their patterns. And just by me going through what I went through with these people, I see what's going on. And I know, how things are going to play out because I've been through this shit already. I know what the hell these people are about. I know, how they operate. I know what they do. I know what they're about, you know. So I'm able to be like, hey, you know, if you follow these guys, this is what's going to end up happening because it happened to me.
Yeah, I swapped sides. You know, the side I'm on now don't even hate you, man. You know what I'm saying? They don't even talk about you like that. The side I'm on is they want to hurt that white bastard when he comes back.
Honestly, you know, one thing I would love to see, if they could, the thing I would love to see is, get those guys to go after the motherfuckers that are going after me, because these motherfuckers, dude, I don't know if you know or not, dude, but these guys that are going at my throat, dude, they literally have, God knows how many, I've counted at least 3 or 4 Facebook groups with over 1,000 people in there talking shit.
Yeah, I saw one when I was trying to look you back up to tell you this stuff, and they were all.
Yeah, my main, the one you probably found was probably my main Facebook is probably the one that you first found, and shit. But I'm not able to talk on that one for 4 or 5 more days because the trolls went in and said oh, I was doing this and doing that, but I really wasn't. So Facebook put me in Facebook jail, and now I'm not allowed to talk to my friends on my main account for fucking 5 or 6 more days.
Who's Gary? Who's the person that William was attacking?
No.
Do what?
Hold on, let me find it real quick.
You talking about Kate, the one that started all this shit?
No. Hold on.
I got some dirt on her as well, dude.
Ellie Klinger. Eli Klinger?
That's a personal. She's one of my personal friends.
I wanted to warn her, or maybe you. I hope you already have warned her how dangerous Mr. William Glory Hall actually can be. So.
Oh, she already knows. Okay. She already knows, and she's got his ass on lock, dude.
He's a dangerous man.
She's got it to where every time he messages her, she don't even fucking worry about it. She just goes in and blocks him, and just goes about her day.
He's a dangerous guy.
I have no idea.
What's up, Matt?
Casper was barking at somebody.
Oh, I thought that was Rugrat the whole time. I thought Rugrat was
Rugrat's downstairs fucking doing something. I don't know what the fuck he's doing. Probably fucking either playing with his toys or sleeping, knowing him.
But yeah, man, I wanted to catch up because, you know, it's it's been years since we fucking talked. And, you know, it's all this shit's going down. I'm actually friends with, I'd like you to meet him sometime. I'm not going to say his actual name. You probably know Marshall Mathers IV.
I don't know if I do or not.
Well, it's a guy named Isaac. I'm not going to say his last
name. Oh! Okay, I think I know who you're talking about now.
I think you could help him because, you know, you live that neat lifestyle. He lives it too, but he thinks he can't get a girlfriend because of it. And you've had so many girlfriends, you know?
Yeah, but honestly, dude, at this, you can ask Matt, dude. Ever since splitting it off with my now current ex, Jasmine, dude, I've been single for a fucking minute, bro.
A dry spell.
Well, no, it's not that. It's the fact that, when I do get with somebody, I don't want them to be caught in the crossfire of what I'm having to deal with, you know? I don't want the trolls going after them and attacking them. So, you know, I'm trying to get rid of these guys first so I can go back to that normal life that I had.
Yeah, you got to get rid of them trolls, man. I think the best way would be just leave the internet. You know, and like if you.
No, that's why what I did was I basically posted a video on my main channel this morning being like, look, you know, I got real life shit that I'm working on. I got stuff that I'm doing. You know, I don't need this shit. I'm out, dude. Like, I'm done with this shit. And what I'm trying to prove to them by leaving is I'm basically showing them, like, you know, watch how fast y'all's content crumbles when I'm gone. Like, during, like, for prime example, when I was going through all that court shit, right? When I was in and out of court for those several months, I was barely on at all. Didn't post anything to YouTube or nothing. And, dude, they were fucking suffering, dude. They were, you can ask Matt, dude, they were fucking begging for fucking content.
Oh, man, Marty got fucking mad at me, Nick. He got mad because I sent someone to help you out during all that. His name was Film Finance Freddy. He was going to give you money and stuff, but y'all chased him off the porch.
Wait, that was you?
Yeah, he said, have you heard of, you know, of Spooky? He said that to you. I could find the clips on.
Oh, shit. Dude, I honest to God thought, bro, I honest to God thought that he was a fucking troll, dude.
No, that was my buddy. I'm not going to say his actual name, but Film Finance.
Yeah, Freddy. I know who you're talking about. Yeah, dude.
He's anti-Marty. Like
okay, Marty,
he's film, the film financer instead of music business. You know what I'm saying? He's the anti-Marty.
Yeah. And what's funny, and dude, get this. One thing that Matt can even tell you, Marty ain't in the fucking music business.
No, he's not. Another
thing that I found out, dude, one thing I found out is that if the main guy that ran Sony saw what Marty was doing, dude, he can leak, like, that dude can legally sue Marty because he's using his image to fuck, to do what he's doing.
Sorry about that.
I hear you, dude.
But I sent someone to help you. I'll chase them off the porch, though. He's going to
get you. I do apologize to that, man. I do sincerely apologize. Just, dude, you got to understand, man. I've had so many people showing up here, and
yeah, you thought he was gonna try to hit you with a bat, probably, but he was trying to give you a fat stack, man. He's trying to give you a wad.
I do genuinely apologize. Like, next time you talk to him, man, tell him that I do apologize and explain to him that I did not realize that he was here to help out. It's just seeing as, because like I watched the video, and like my first thoughts were, okay, this dude's a fucking troll.
No, he was excited to meet you and everything. Is he's got some money and you know it's he.
I do apologize for that, man. I do sincerely apologize for that, bro.
Hey, Gar.
What's up, Matt?
I am building a magic deck that you are going to hate.
Now, send me the damn schematic, man. Send it to me. I'll look at it.
It's not fully built yet, but you know what it does.
What's it do, bro?
Let me put it to you this way. Anytime I attack or put one card on the field, if it makes a copy of it like a token, I gain a crap ton of life.
Fuck yeah. Cyraxx, you still fuck with magic?
A little bit, yeah. I haven't messed with it in a while because like, I just got the gaming PC that I got now from one of my friends and shit. Like, I've had it for since like... Matt, when did I get this computer hooked up? Like, what, last month sometime?
I don't know.
It hasn't been that long. It's been like a couple months. So, like, I'm still getting everything set up and whatnot on it. Like, I do have Steam. I do have So I am going to be, matter of fact, Matt, remind me tomorrow that I need to download Magic on Steam.
Yeah, I know Jared wanted to play you in it, Jared Genesis. I found he was a fucking true sicko, though. He admitted that to me.
Oh yeah, dude. Jared Genesis.
Have you seen the Lord of the Rings set?
Oh yeah, the Magic Universes Beyond thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's some pretty sick cards in there, man. That one ring sold.
Did you see one that was called Aragorn and Aaron Wed?
Yeah, they made Aragorn black. I was like, what? Aragorn's a white dude.
Well, yeah, right. That's what right? I read the book.
Yeah, what about it though, Matt?
That's actually my commander. If you read it carefully, you'll understand the deck perfectly.
Oh.
When it enters the battlefield or attacks, For each creature on the battlefield, I gain one life, and each creature gets a 1/1 buff.
Alright, so you're just going to keep making tokens infinitely with doubling season or something?
How about try this, angel tokens?
Sweet, man, do it.
So, here's the thing. I get a 4/4 angel, I gain 4 life. But here's the thing. I got a couple other cards that say, when a creature enters the battlefield, I gain life. Or, if I gain life, gain double that life. Or, if an angel, gain 4 life, and so on and so forth.
Oh, shit.
In other words, I'll gain like 25 life for just one angel.
That's pretty nuts, man. That's a nutso deck. See, I had to sell all my Magic the Gathering cards. It got so bad for me. See, Cyraxx was right about all that. He was right. I fell into some hard times.
All that's called karma.
Yeah, it was karma, man. I shouldn't have listened to those Betty White people, man. They were fucked up.
What all happened, like, after me and you stopped talking, dude, like, what all went down with those guys?
So, the Betty White people, like, they took the money out of my account after they put it in there, and I'd only got to spend a little bit of it. And then somebody contacted me, Agent K or some shit like that is his name. I probably shouldn't have said that. Or Agent KF or something like that. This motherfucker, he got me onto the White Bowser, and then I started getting paid by these other folks. And now I work with them. I don't work for those damn slanderous trolls anymore, man. They're like,
yeah. Because honestly, it's like I was telling Matt and even a couple of the guys that I'm good friends with that I work with here and there. Like, we've all said the same exact thing, that the people that these trolls need to be going after are people like White Bowser, are people like Tony that are actually out there doing this shit.
People like Kuro. Kuro is the worst. Like, Tony's bad. Like, Tony Black Dragon, he's bad, but, you know, he's at least he's in a wheelchair. They can run from him. But Kuro is out here, like, literally grabbing kids, stabbing people, sexually assaulting her partners. And it's just, like, you ought to look into her, Syra. You ought to contact her. Because
I'll definitely look into her shit, dude, for sure. Another one that's fucking sick is that one Daniel Larson, dude.
Oh,
I actually found out, I found out that Daniel ended up getting arrested again recently.
Good, he needs to be in jail. He's a monster.
Honestly, dude, I don't know what he got arrested for, but from what I understand, he swung on a police officer again. I don't know. Like, if that's true, or if it's like he did something else, but I will admit, I've seen the videos of this dude actually doing some serious, outrageously fucked up shit. And it's like, that dude does need to be arrested.
What was it like in jail, man? What was that like for you?
Believe it or not, dude, that wasn't my first time. That was actually my second time, but it was still like, even my family knew it was fucked up. Like, granted, I did get hooked up. Linked up with a couple that were actually really good dudes. Like, they actually looked out for me and shit. And I actually sat down, and these guys, like, they had been in and out of jail several times. Like, dude, there was one kid in there that was brand new. Like, this kid was new. Like, dude, this kid was still in high school. And he ended up doing jail time, and I ended up talking to this kid. I'm like, yo, like, what the fuck did you do to get in here? And he explained that he was basically wrong place, wrong time kind of situation. I was like, and I told him straight, I was like, dude, take it from me, dude. Don't fucking do that shit again. Like, be more fucking careful about where you're at.
When they asked, how did you explain it to other inmates, like, when they asked why you were in there?
I explained to them the whole situation of that we had some people coming onto our property that weren't supposed to be there. They kept on coming onto our property and would not leave. They refused to leave. So I told them, I was like, my family told them to leave, which obviously by the videos y'all can tell that, you know, we were telling them to leave. They wouldn't do it. So I told them, I was like, I went out there with a baseball bat and gave them a fair fucking warning and told them, like, look, you need to leave or you're getting swung on. And they wouldn't leave, so I ended up swinging on them. And the one dude that I was talking to, like, he was an older guy, but he was super fucking cool. He's been in and out of jail for, like, most of his life. So, like, he's pretty much a regular, I guess you could say. But, like, he was super, super cool, super chill dude. Like, he was very respectful, very nice dude.
So, it's and nothing like these cartoons of you getting raped in there. So, nothing like that?
No, not at all, dude. No. If anything, a lot of the people in there looked out for me, dude. Like, I wasn't in there except maybe, like, a day. And they ended up fucking looking out for me and shit. Like I had, they had done the, you know, the paper check. They're like, hey, like, what are you in for? And I showed them my papers. They did a check. And they're like, dude, like, you're a solid fucking dude. And the one dude was like, there was one big fucking black stocky dude that I actually ended up getting celled up with just overnight.
Oh, shit.
He was a good dude. Like, this guy had a good fucking head on his shoulders.
He was a big black dude, like Big Bubba, like a big black man?
Like, more like, I would say kind of like, how do I put it? He was almost like a cross of, like, Randy Orton meets Samuel, no, not Samuel L. Jackson, but the dude that plays, the guy that plays Blade, Wesley Snipes, like, he was that kind of dude. Like, he was skinny, but you can tell this dude fucking worked out. Like, he was a good dude, though. Like, he was super respectful. And he came out and he was like, yo, like, because he could tell that I had a lot on my fucking mind. Like, he could fucking tell that I was, like, I was not doing well. So he sat down, like, he pulled me aside in the cell. He's like, dude, like, he was like, I may not know you, but I can tell when someone's going through some shit. So he was like, just lay it out there, be fucking honest, you know, tell me what the fuck's up. And I sat down and I explained the whole situation from start to finish. And he was like, dude, like, and he said the same thing that everybody else with a half a brain has said. He's like, dude, you fucked up. You made a mistake. You owned up to those mistakes. And he was like, yeah, you maybe shouldn't have swung that bat, but you know, you were just doing what you had to do to protect your family because you didn't know if that dude was going to fucking swing on you. He's like, as far as I'm concerned, you're solid in my books. And then, he's like, yeah, but the whole shit with that K-chick may not have been the smartest move you made, but he was like, he was like, let me give you some words of wisdom. Eventually, these guys are going to fuck off and move on because he actually has a son that ended up getting caught up in some very, very similar shit.
Oh,
so he was not, yeah, so he wasn't a stranger to this type of stuff. And he was like, I'm going to tell you exactly what I told my son. He was like, yeah, you fucked up. You made a mistake. But from what I can see, and from what you're telling me, and just by how I'm able to read you, I can tell that, you know, you're a good dude. You learned your lesson. And he was like, he did say, but next time, he's like, you end up in here again. Like, I'm still going to look out for you, but just know that you're going to get a fucking earful if you end up in here again. And he was like, just try not to fucking swing on anybody anymore. And he's like, next time, call the police, let them deal with it. I was like, yeah, I know. But the dude was a nice dude. Like, he was doing, I guess he got busted on, it was like right before weed became legal here in Ohio. He ended up getting busted on having a few weed plants. Literally a few months before weed got legalized, he ended up getting busted. And his son's been in and out of jail with law enforcement and shit and whatnot because, you know, his son smokes and chill at that, and his son's dealt with a lot of similar shit of what I've dealt with. And he's like, dude, he's like, the way I see it, and I love how he put this. The dude was like, the way I see it, these guys, they ain't got a chance in hell at surviving out in the dark. He was like, all these guys do is sit behind a fucking screen and talk shit to people for no fucking reason but to fill their own fucking egos.
But, like, when Marty, like, when Nick or whatever, he came up there and, like, y'all fought, who won that fight?
That you can rely on. But it was like, these guys out here that are running their mouths, he was like, just remember this. These guys out here that talk all this shit, they talk a big game, but very, very, very rarely can they ever back it up. And he was like, he also said, he was like, next time, just be careful of who you fucking talk to, because he was like, dude, like, these chicks, they'll get you tripped up real quick if you're not fucking careful. And he was like, just be more careful of who you fucking talk to, because these chicks out here doing this shit, he's like, they ain't nothing but fucking trouble. And I was like, I know, I kind of...
They'll fucking trick you, man. When Marty's saying stuff, how was that? Like, because we weren't talking anymore then. Like, who won that fight? Because I saw you bruised up. I didn't see what old fucking Musical Business Martin looked like.
So what happened was, when you watched the video back, is I went over there to confront him, right? Like, obviously, I went over there to confront him and shit like that. Well, he ended up stepping off the porch, and it was wet outside, obviously.
Yeah.
Like, it was obviously wet out, because it had just been raining earlier that night. Well, he came off the porch, and I could tell he was ready to fucking go. Like, he had his fists up, like, he was ready to fucking roam. So I fucking charged him, because I knew what was up. It was gonna go one of two ways. Either I was gonna knock him in the fucking face, or I was gonna get, you know, smacked up right then and there, you know, one and done. Well, instead of me, I landed a couple hits on him when we were standing. Well, when he went to swing at me, like he went to swing like this, like he went to do a hammer fist like that, like an over the head hammer fist, ended up missing. And ended up falling on top of me, and before I could even get up, this dude literally had me fucking spun around and was literally beating the fucking shit out of me right in the fucking face. And all I could do was just sit there like this and just hold my head and try to, you know, block it as much as I fucking could.
And that's the truth. And he ended up, no swings in on him.
Unfortunately, no. I only got like one or two in when we were standing, and that was it. And then he ended up hammer fisting me. We both fell because it was wet. And yeah, he ended up just so fucking.
It got wet when Marty was on top of you?
No, it was already wet out. It was wet out because it had been. Yeah, it had been raining earlier that night. So he just kept on, you know, pounding me. And the only reason why. Only reason why he got off of me was because one of my neighbors had heard me screaming for help, because the way this dude was hitting me, I honestly thought that he was gonna fucking kill me. Like, that dude weighs at least 300 pounds. At least.
He's a big boy. He is.
Like, he's not light at all. And, like, one of our neighbors, you know, heard me screaming. And the only reason why Marty got off me is because that dude Tony was like, yo, get the fuck off then. And, like, right as soon as Marty looked up, that's when he yanked me up. I got home. I didn't know how bad shit was. I go into the bathroom and all I see is just my fucking nose just completely fucked. Like, I had blood leaking from my nose. We honestly thought that my nose was broke. We called the police and let them know what was up. They made a report about it.
I really like what you said on your stream afterwards. I even like made a little video on my old channel because I was kind of proud of it. You said, I'm still standing. So I played that Elton John song. I'm still standing.
Right, and it's true, dude. You know, and that's why I told people, yeah, I may have lost that fight, but at least I fucking showed up.
You did show up, Cyraxx. You did, Chance. You certainly did. That's the thing. It's like, as long as you... I used to fight for fun, you know?
Yeah.
And some people wouldn't have the balls to even throw a punch. And it's like, you know, you go in and you have fun with it. That's the way I see it.
Right.
You get beat, so what? You had your fun. You got your...
Right, like, you go in, hands, and, you know... And honestly, dude, that's the way that it should be, man. It shouldn't be like, oh, you know, you show up with all your friends and, you know, have a bunch of weapons and this and that. No, like, that shit don't need to happen. Like, it needs to go back to how when we were kids, dude. And even Matt can agree with this, man. Back in the day, man, it used to be if you had a beef with somebody and y'all wanted to throw down, you know, y'all showed up, y'all fought, and then y'all shook hands and went home afterwards. Maybe even cracked a couple cold ones with the dude. Who knows?
And I'm glad, Chance. I'm glad we reached out, man. And you know, I guess I probably do owe you an apology for all the Betty White stuff.
That's all good, man. No worries. Dude, honestly, man. Honestly, dude, I kind of figured that they were fucking with you in some way, shape, or form. And now, yeah. Now I understand how and even why. Like, I get
lesson around the time that fat bitch Jasmine. I'm sorry, I just don't like her.
Oh, I don't blame. Hey, it's all good, dude. It's all good.
You know, she just wanted the clout. You know,
that's like with that other chick that I had dated that had hit me up on Instagram. Like, don't get me wrong, I messaged that chick. Me and her talk.
Man, did you get her nudes? Did you get her nudes?
The one chick that was from Instagram?
The hottie from Australia with the bad teeth, but she had a nice banging body and she had cute eyes.
Believe it or not, dude, that shit was all... That was actually on my old Discord that I no longer have access to.
Shit, you have Discord now? You can join mine if you want. Send you a link.
I'll see what I can do for sure, man.
I'll send you a link later.
All right, for sure.
I don't know how people will treat you there. I mean, it's a nice group of people now since I switched sides, since I got rid of all
those people. And honestly, dude, like, and, you know, if they need any kind of evidence to, you know, for me to show what these people are really about, like, you can ask Matt, dude. I've got plenty of shit on these guys. Like, the shit they talk, they're brazen with it. They don't give a fuck. Like, they put it out there and don't fucking care. And it's
I also have stuff on William.
That is true. That's very true, man. You do. But hey, give me just a second, guys. I'll be right back. I just gotta go check something. Hey, Matt, show them some of the stuff that you've been working with deck wise while I take care of this.
Oh, yeah. Show me your cards. Show me your cards, boy. God damn it. My fucking mic.
Okay, what happens to your camera?
Hey, what's up, brother?
What happened to your camera?
Oh, I never had a webcam. I'd have to use a phone to fucking talk face to face.
Ah, okay.
Rice.
Right up to Vorna.
Get the. Under the deck. Did you... Damn, Earhead? You went there.
He said.
You fucked me up for Xbox, and I read it as Beetlejuice. I was like, man, I didn't even know they made a Beetlejuice game on Xbox, but it's the Bruce Lee game. What you know about Bruce Lee, Chance? What you know about him?
What do you want to know?
Shit, do you ever do a Keet Jun Do or whatever it's called? Do you ever do that?
No, but I have actually studied it. What I've done with him is I've basically taken, like, the philosophy side of what he talks about a lot. And Matt here actually helped kickstart that a little bit. He kind of broke it down to, like, hey, this is what he's getting at with this.
So he showed you
and
the first
he kind of broke it.
That movie, Enter the Dragon, he showed you that for the first time?
No. He basically broke down, like, I already knew about Enter the Dragon. I had already watched that, like, at least 100 times already beforehand. But I started watching some footage afterwards, and, like, you do realize what he's getting at when he talks about, you know, this, that, and the other. And I was like, yes and no. I kind of get the outline of it, but Matt went into full-on detail about like what the philosophy side of it was. And once he explained it, I was like, I never thought about that shit like that until now. Holy shit.
And
Because
speaking
like
of.
a lot of people don't realize that Bruce he was very philosophical. Yo, Matt, what card's that?
What does that name say?
I can barely read it, dude.
Ramos
Yeah, dude,
Dragon
I got
Engine. That's the Dragon Engine, Cyraxx.
Oh, shit.
Y'all both know what that card is. Now, here's one I know y'all know.
No shit. I've seen you use that card on more than one occasion.
So Chance, man, now that we're buddy pals again, now that we're friends. Shit, you want to hang out sometime? You want to talk more about some
Hey,
shit?
dude.
I'm glad, man, that fat bitch is out of the picture because, you know, she hated me. She
Honestly,
wasn't.
dude, like looking back now, like you can't even ask Matt, dude. Even Matt had a weird feeling about her. And Matt, what was your exact words to me about the shit she had been doing? Like, what were your exact words to me about that shit?
Gut instinct.
Yeah, well, yeah, but what was it that you said about her that made you feel like something was up?
It was just something my gut was telling me.
Well, all right, so what I'm getting at is explain what your gut was telling you.
That something wasn't right. That how did I explain it?
She
Basically
seemed like
fake.
something was wrong.
She seemed fake to me too. She seemed really fake to me.
Right, and I kind of started noticing it like the more that time went on, I kind of started noticing the more, fake side of things. And I was like, I don't fucking need this shit. Like I said, like, I even told her straight up, like, in the voice message, before I stopped contacting her, I was like, look, like, I'm not mad at you. And if anything, I want to thank you. And I showed her, I was like, this is what I want to thank you for. I want to thank you for showing me that I can do way fucking better than this. Because what you're doing is beyond fucked up. And I don't fucking need that in my life. And then there was an incident beforehand that really like set me off where like me and this is like back when, things were going really good. And this is what really kind of gave me the red flag right off the rip was there was a point where she was like, because me and her had gotten to on the subject of, about maybe one day having kids or whatever and whatnot. And me and her were both on board with it. But the thing that tipped me off with her was that she had said, like, yeah, if we have kids, that would be good for extra income. And right as soon as she said that, like, I kind of made up this whole thing of like, hey, I gotta go take care of something real quick. I'll be right back. So I ended up hanging up. And then I ended up, waiting like 4 or 5 minutes before, texting her. And I thought to her, I was like, so you mean to tell me that if we have kids, you wouldn't want to have kids just to raise it and, leave behind a legacy and leave behind something for your kids and, do something like that. But instead, you would rather have kids for financial gain? The fuck's wrong with you? Like, if I'm gonna have a kid with somebody, I would want it to be because, we want to have a kid. We want to raise a kid together, not for financial gain. Like, having a family should be about wanting to have a family, not financial gain. And I ended up cutting her off after that. She ended up coming back, like, a month and a half later, reaching out and apologized. And we ended up talking again for a bit. And then that was the second time when she had told me that she would always be a fan first. And then after that, dude, that's when I was like, dude, enough is enough. Like, I cut her off after that. I was like, dude, no, I'm done.
Like, you asked me to see some more cards. Here's one that I don't think many people do use.
Let's see, what is it, bud? Let's see. Oh, the Kami of Whispered Hopes. Yeah, it's a good one.
Do you know what makes it so broken?
What makes it busted?
Ever thought about putting that card on it?
Let's see. Oh, yeah, that's a combo right there, man. That's a fucking combo. Cyraxx, what's your favorite Magic the Gathering combo?
That actually is a combo.
You're gonna use that Beetle right there, huh? I know a guy named Beetle. He showed me a crazy lady the other night that had her tits out, like, constantly. Cyraxx,
oh,
she was racist, but she had her tits out all the time. Like, every time you'd look at her, her boobies were out. And
what the fuck?
She said it was okay for YouTube because her nipples were covered. And she knew that one
guy. That don't, dude, do you really think YouTube gives a fuck? They don't. They will fucking ban your ass real quick.
And she.
Here's one of the coup de grace cards that I have in the deck.
That coup de grace, huh? Coup de grace. Oh, yeah. You can break that one for sure, man. That one.
Dang.
You can put all the counters on it at once, man. And just bam, win the fucking game.
Hey, how's that one for you, bro?
What's that, bro? What's that?
Check this card out.
Worn and Realm Breaker.
Oh, hell yeah. I love Planeswalkers, man. I used to fuck with some Planeswalkers hardcore. I made super friends back in the day.
That's another deck I'm working on. Is Super Friends.
Super Friends. That's what me and Cyraxx is going to be, right? Chance, we're going to be super friends again.
Hey, you never know.
Instead of all that dirty old trolling shit, man.
Like, honestly, dude, like, you can ask Matt, man. All I've been trying to do recently is just get my fucking life back to normal, dude.
Yeah, it was that Roddy Beltran, man. I didn't appreciate him trying to troll you because he's in the even worse shit, you know. And I wanted to warn you about all that UIS. I'd ignore them, like they're not even worth responding to.
And that's why I made that video on my main account that I made this morning, basically saying, hey, like, you know, y'all think that you can do this? Well, here's me yanking y'all's content. See you later. I got real life shit I could be doing. Fuck this.
Exactly, man. We're just bullshitting and stuff right now, you know. Like, there's real world shit. Remember when you said that the internet and the real world were the same thing? That's one of the last things we said to each other. And I told you, I said, I think I was right on that one. I was like, no, they're not. You know, because on the internet, you know, people live different lives and they lie. And see,
like, the point that I was making with that is, like, you know, and I was agreeing with you that, yeah, they're two separate worlds. But at the same time, sometimes the people that, like, there are still real people involved. There's still real shit that can happen. Like, take my situation, for example. It started on the internet and then spilled out into real life. And that's kind of what I was getting at. It's like, yeah, like all this stuff on the internet, yeah, that's internet stuff, whatever. But at the same time, in certain circumstances, real shit can come of it.
Oh man, speaking of real shit, like, is it real for real? Like, your dad, something about like becoming a woman or something? Like, is your dad?
Oh, my biological sperm donor. Yeah, that did happen, unfortunately.
Damn.
Now, the worst thing that happened was my fucking adoptive dad basically disowning me on Marty's panel, dude.
Ed?
Not Ed, my adoptive dad, the one that helped raise me as a kid.
Oh, and he went on Marty's panel.
You remember the one I was talking about that was in the military?
Yeah, that guy.
Yeah, he ended up going on Marty's panel. And I don't know how the hell Marty and them got a hold of him. I don't even know how they
It's
found
probably
him.
William Glory Hole's like tactical espionage magic or something, man. That dude's like Otacon mixed with the revolver guy.
Something, yeah. Like the dude knows a lot of shit. But I ended up seeing, at first I didn't believe it. And then I sat down and I saw him up on Marty's panel. I'm like, hang on one sec. Give me one sec. I'll just wait. I was gonna go there. I'll be right back. I'm away.
So Matt. What you been doing with your life, man? You been playing any good games like Zero is a it'll make you anyway mod but you realize and look that's it. First you see this band and he started and she and man take care of that. You need to know you could learn from that series. And I guess yeah, I was telling Matt the synopsis of Yakuza 0 and Yakuza 1. So, and by the time Yakuza 8 comes out, I'll be finished. So he can just jump on Yakuza 8 and know everything already.
Right, exactly. Because I've played all the Yakuza games, man. They're fucking good. I even also, because they did a port over from PlayStation, I ended up playing and beating Ghostwire Tokyo.
Damn, I ain't got to play that yet. I heard it was spooky.
Dude, it's scary, but it's fucking fun, dude.
It's one thing we can both agree on, me and Chance, the monsters that they did them correctly.
That's true, they did.
And honorably.
Oh, dude, speaking of which, yo, Gar, did you see what, did you know that a Jelly Roll actually ended up going to one of the live events recently?
Who did?
Jelly Roll. He actually was.
Yeah, I used to smoke weed with him.
Bro, you know that he helped Randy Orton win his first fight back, right?
Nah, I didn't know that. I never, like, fucked with Randy Orton. Like...
Bro, it was funny as fuck. This dude kept on giving Jelly Roll shit while Randy was down. And the dude saw Jelly, kept fucking with him. Jelly fucking stood up and fucking pushed the dude down. Didn't even think twice. He was like, boom. Here, let me see if I can pull up the footage, man. I promise you're gonna fucking laugh at this shit. Let me see if I can... Let me switch over here. Alright, let's go here. Let's go...
I'm sure this will turn out to be a big mess. It could be
over. Ah, this is a
mess. Yeah. No one is in control.
And
now the viper is coiled to strike.
Oh, damn.
Terrifying sight in W.
Hang on, wrong tab.
You can share the screen if you want. Look at
yeah, I know. I was trying to get the right tab. There we go. All right, there we go.
You gotta show that Pornhub tab, man. I've seen dirty things you've been wanking to, bro.
Smartass. Hey, you ready for this shit, dude?
Yeah, let me see this wrestling, man. I got a friend named Zippity who loves wrestling.
Hey, me and him would get along, though, dude. JD
Mysterio out of harm's way. Oh shit, is he gonna fuck him? What's going on? It looks like a slideshow on my end. Can you like raise the...
Oh, here it goes, here it goes.
Oh, it's Jelly Roll, man. I used to smoke weed with that fella.
Yeah.
Damn.
There he goes again. Bye, Dom.
Yeah, it's going slideshow mode for me. It's kind of funny, though, Cyraxx. It's kind of funny.
Randy Orton now with Dominic. Sit down, Dom.
Randy, you are dominating there. Caught up in our announce cables here and spine first on our monitor. This audience is sick in the head. And another one! JD McDonough, this guy has no brains. Sorry, but he doesn't. He's all hard though. Oh!
Man, he's just tackling him to the ground, gonna suck him up, suck him down.
Trying to take advantage. Now looking for the 619 away. Orton and Dominic's got an opportunity. Dominic gonna go up to the top rope. Randy's in trouble. Mysterio, top rope, front slash, nobody home.
Dumbass.
Oh, shit. Cyraxx, Chance.
What's up? Matt,
I'm streaming apparently. I didn't know.
Wait, who's streaming?
Me.
Oh, it's all good.
I had no idea, man.
That's all good.
Oh, shit. Found this one. There you go. This guy named Biff that I found recently. He does some good, like, documentaries and shit. So he did one on you apparently 2 weeks ago, man. I had no idea. I'll probably watch that later. See what he says about my good buddy pal, man. See, I'm glad we're getting all this shit out of the rug, you know what I'm saying? And like not fucking lying and being conniving and you know, being real with each other again.
Right.
Picking Preacher, I hate that fat bastard.
Shit.
I hate this motherfucker. Can't stand
it. Yo, guys, you got to bounce. You got to take me on the call. Matt, I'll call you back here and there. Gar, I'll talk to you later on, man. Peace.
Yeah, hit me up, man. Hit me up. Hey, Matt.